welcome to Channel 48. Today I'm here with the Samsung Galaxy G320FN. This video will as well be for those that have the models 320F, M and G. So what's up with this phone? Well, I got this phone on a Christmas Eve when I was broadcasting live here on YouTube. Somebody by the name of someone, he bought this phone for me, for us, so I could make reviews about it. And at that time, there was not too much going on for this phone. Well, we do have two developers by the name of Faltisal and G-Man that on a regular basis, you know, update whatever they created for this phone. And the ROM that they created for this phone is a very nice working Nougat version of Android. So there is no Android 8 or Android 9 for this phone. So those that are asking for that, to them I want to say be very happy that you don't have to be on Android 5.11, because that is exactly what this phone was left behind with from Samsung. We all know 5.11 is kind of outdated. This old software, and if you're not getting any updates anymore, then in fact your phone becomes your enemy, because it might start doing things that will harm you. So that's why we have the custom ROM world and the independent developers that put their time and effort into certain phones, and they do it in a sort of organization. And you know, we have all sorts of things like Android Police and you know, XDA developers, guys that know about what is crack-a-lacking. So they also look at whatever is being created by certain people. And the less support a phone has in custom ROM world, the more these ROMs will be inspected by the higher level, you know, developers. So using a custom ROM doesn't necessarily mean that you're using bad software. Some companies, big companies, official companies want to make you believe that whenever you use some custom ROM, that in fact your device is becoming a danger to you. I think it's even more a big bigger danger if you're on some old Jelly Bean or KitKat version with outdated software. What is it? Are you bringing me a message? Oh, go eat the Marfa flowers. So, G-Man and Faltisal are two developers. They are helping each other. I don't know which one is doing the developing, but these two names, they go together with this ROM that I'm gonna show you. I always, as well, dress up the ROMs from these guys. You know, and I give it extra attention. If you're gonna look for the G320FN on Google, you will surely find my videos all the way on top, because I make many videos about their ROMs. What they create is a standard Lineage OS ROM that in fact is being updated with the latest security patches, in this case from June 2019. Just think of it, 2019. So that is fantastic. It's a whole lot of work to implement these updates. Really, trust me, it's a whole lot of work. So we must be very grateful that we have Faltisal and G-Man, you know, at least taking the time to still work on this phone. So we must keep making videos, and we must keep using our G320FN or the F or the G, the M, you know, keep using these phones. Don't just, you know, sell them to someone that at a certain moment will put it aside and not use it anymore, because then development will also, get less and it will die out at a certain moment. So we must keep these phones alive. That's why I'm still, you know, keeping all these phones that are getting support alive, making videos about them, you know, show the people what's crack-a-lacking, etc., etc. Okay, let's get started. If you are still using the official firmware, then you must go into the developer's options by going about the phone, you know, and then at the software you scroll down until you see build number. Tap it 8 times until you're gonna see you just enable developer's options. Go one page back, go into the developer's options and turn on boot unlock. It's very important, okay? That will unlock the bootloader. Then you're gonna head up to the link that you're gonna find in my description to the site of Gman and Foutisal. And then you're gonna find a twerp version, yeah? Read good, go and read and study about the phone so you also understand the procedures that you're gonna do and you start learning to get to know the phone, okay? So go read whatever it's saying there and download the twerp file. It will be delivered in a TAR format. And when you downloaded it to your computer, make sure you have a computer with Arden and with the Samsung USB drivers installed. In fact, I don't want to, you know, keep saying this all the time. So, but you know, you never know. We have some new people yesterday as well. Spain, you know, he has this tablet, this 10-inch tablet, and I kind of helped him out. The previous video that I created was, in fact, a video that I created special for him to help him out, you know, to fix his tablet. I'm not sure if he managed. He just said he could not get into twerp again, but he installed the ROM. So at least he made a step. These are people that don't know about these kinds of things and that, you know, kind of learn thanks to my videos and the videos from many other YouTubers here, you know, how to update their phone, how to, you know, make it good again. So whenever you flash the twerp and you're gonna reboot the phone, then you can kick out the battery, and that's exactly what I'm gonna do now. So we're gonna go from that point, okay? And you also have copied the firmware that you're gonna install. So we just installed twerp, right? And you have a little micro SD card where you already copied the Lineage OS from this build to the micro SD card. You pop it in, so it's in there. All right, so we just installed twerp, the phone went off, so we're gonna go from there. First things first, we're gonna hold the volume button up, the home, and then we're gonna press power. The moment we see the logo, we let go of the buttons. That will bring us in the brand new just installed twerp. This is what you should see, okay? If you see something else with lines, then it did not go good. All right, so the first thing that you're gonna do is you're gonna wipe, and you're gonna do advanced wipe, Dalvik. My thingy is a little bit data. You see the Dalvik system data and catch. You could also wipe the internal storage. That will clean up the phone completely and you will get a brand new phone in return. Okay, so if you made a backup of all the things that you need needed from the phone to your computer, then you can also hit internal storage. That will wipe the complete drive. Okay, I will not do it because I have a file on there that I need for this video so we can install the ROM. So it just finished the wiping. We go back home, we hit install, and then we scroll down, because up here I have the Lineage OS. It's called Lineage OS 14.1 Q modded Lineage 14.1 Q modded OS for the G320FN. For the other models, I also downloaded that ROM. I will also create RAM like this. So the other models, the F, G and the M, should not flash this RAM. This RAM is not for you guys. This is only for the G320FN. Okay, the other RAM, as soon as it's done, I will make it really soon. So, and then I will try to upload it as well. Okay, however, you can also go to the site of Gman and Valticel and get only the Lineage OS. You don't have to install my ROM. In my ROM, however, you're gonna get, well, I'm gonna show it to you. You're gonna get great applications. You're gonna get great looks. You're gonna have Nova Launcher instead of Trebuchet. You will have a built-in firewall if you're gonna root the device as well. Rooting the device will be very easy. You can do that with SuperSU, or you can as well use Magisk 19. Okay. And I've been testing this RAM since the day before yesterday, and I can tell you that I'm very happy about the results. Really, I am. So we're just gonna reboot now, because in fact I'm not gonna root this phone, not at this moment. I'm gonna do that in my own time. But you can also as well install root, and the Magisk manager is already installed in the ROM. So yeah, you will have no problems. How you say that? Turning on the apps that have permission or don't have permission. This is the latest Google Android Q boot animation, and it's black. It's better for your eyes. It looks very nice in the dark. It looks as if these balls are kind of jumping. It's really nice in the dark. If you look at it at night in a dark room, then it's almost as if these little dots are jumping out of the screen like a little hologram. But I can show you the real-time boot, but I can also skip that and get back to you whenever this is booted up. It will take about 5 minutes. Now I must tell you that I also created two other ROMs for this device. The second one I will not release yet, but the other is in fact unofficial EROM modded Lineage OS for the G320FN, including the e-boot animation and the e-store built in, so you can immediately go ahead and download applications that you want to install. But I did not release that one yet. I'm still waiting a bit. I'm not sure if EROM will like it that I will do a thing like that, because in fact I went to their whatever Telegram group and asked them if it was okay to implement their app store in unsupported ROMs by E. And in fact, yeah, they are also looking for developers to port ROMs to E, you by using the E whatever to build ROMs. And yeah, so I'm not even sure if I can do that, so I must first talk to these guys if I can mod ROMs in kind of e-modeled, including the Bliss launcher as well. So I'm not sure about that. I still have to talk to these guys about that. But for now, we have the Google Pixel, the dark Pixel boot animation, and it's almost there. And if you're gonna flash this ROM, the only things that are changed in the ROM is that Trebuchet is removed. And of course, extra applications are implemented, so you can get started immediately after flashing the ROM. You don't have to go to the internet first to go and download all these things. And as well, whenever you're gonna do a reset and wipe, then the room will come back just like this. So yeah, what is cooler than that? And there we are. We just booted up into Linux OS. And there we go. Next. Next. Skip. Skip anyway. Skip. Next. 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 Start. And there we go. And instead of the Trebuchet launcher, you will immediately get the Nova launcher. As you know, the Nova launcher is as well adapted by me because I think it's, yeah, together with LaunchShare, I think these are the world's best launchers, yeah, ever created, because they also come without ads and that's these kinds of things. They are very light, they work very good, and they are very, very customizable. Okay, so the applications that you will have are two app stores, APK Pure and another app store, and you as well gonna have ARD MediaTek, so you can watch live TV from Germany. An audio recorder, very good one with customizable mic gain, so you can, you know, put the mic louder or softer depending if you're, you know. Of course, you have open camera as well. Open camera is installed. Great camera to record live events, etc. Because, in fact, you also can adjust the sensitivity of the microphone of this camera. So yeah, I think these are fantastic tools, and they must be, you know, they must be brought to the people in the form of ROMs and you know, mods, these kinds of things. You have a scanner radio, so you can listen to live ATC and police radio, etc. I love doing that. You have Radio Droid. Radio Droid is a world radio that will give you each and every station in the world, including Suriname. Jawel. We have a podcast player that will also let you download podcasts. I most of the time download reggae podcasts with these. We have a screen recorder, of course, that comes with the system, and it as well works very, very, very good. Okay, the coolest is that you can customize the system completely the way you want. Okay, so you can long press, go into the settings. Here you can go to the desktop, and here you can say, for instance, something irritating is, for instance, wallpaper scrolling. I don't like it at all. You know, it makes my wallpaper look stupid. Up here, the icon layout. What can we do here more? The background of the app drawer. You can set it to black and set it to 65% or so. You know, these kinds of things. And we can go back. We can go to the dock. Here we have beautiful dock backgrounds. All sorts of dock backgrounds, platform, a kind of iOS dock that you can, of course, make kind of glassy, transparent with this button here. You have rounded, and of course, you have this one as well. There are many. You can also change the color of the dock. You see that? Here we have a kind of, a lovely dock, something that you don't see too often. Looks a bit like the, what were these phones called again, HTC or so, I think HTC, yeah, the HTC dock. And we can go back here, in fact, we can set this to night mode. You can do all sorts of things, guys. I don't think I have to teach you how to do all these things. You are very smart, you know how to work with apps, and you can go ahead and set up your phone the way you love to set it up. Okay, about the icons, you also can change the icons if you wish. You go to look and feel, and then here on top you can choose out of some icon packs as well. Two of my icon packs, my future icon packs that I'm gonna present, these are the Mac Catalina icon pack and extra icon pack that you can use. I would go for the Mac Catalina icon pack, yeah. And then you will have a different phone, a red smartphone, you see that? And you're gonna have a different
messaging icon. Very nice as well. At least, I'm not sure if you like it. I don't like it. I love it. Really, I do. And up here, you're gonna be able to change each and every icon. Go to edit by hitting the icon. You can go to my icon pack, and then you select, you know, the icon that goes along with it, and then done. Boom, look at that, beautiful. You see that?
So that was it. I hope you love this ROM, this firmware that you can flash onto the G320FN. I say wish you a fantastic Saturday. I have more projects to come up, and in fact, yeah, the G320 revealed a little bit of the next project that is coming up. And yeah, if you want to see that, make sure to hit the, where is it? There, the subscribe button, and yeah, hit that ridiculous notification bell so you will also be updated whenever I upload a new video again. Thank you for watching. This was Puk Darlington, Groningen City. I say, have yourself a beautiful weekend.